From cute fluffy pandas to fearsome predators, here are 10 examples of real living fossils. Number 10. The aardvark. The aardvark is a perfect example of a living fossil. It's a totally unique mammal and has remained unchanged for millions of years. Also known as oryc-ter-opus afer, the word aardvark comes from the Afrikaan language in South Africa. It means earth pig or ground pig. The solitary creature's strong senses of smell and hearing make it an excellent hunter on open grassland. It has a long nose which it uses to sniff out termites and ants. That combined with its tough hide, big claws, and long sticky tongue means this critter creates a big headache for any insects crossing its path. The aardvark emerges at night from a burrow. They're great burrowers and can dig a shelter for themselves surprisingly quickly with their claws. Those claws come in really handy when tucking into a termite burrow. The aardvark sticks its 1.5-foot tongue in the hole and licks out the unlucky inhabitants. It has a strong tail which can be used to brace itself as it feeds. The tail can also be used as a club. The aardvark is a highly specialized animal that has all kinds of talents. Number 9. The red panda. Everyone loves the giant black and white panda, but did you know that this isn't the original? The word panda was first used to describe this little fellow in 1825 by Frederick Cuvier, a zoologist from France. Its other, less catchy title is Aelurus fulgens, which means fire-colored cat, even though it isn't a cat. It actually has its own family name, Aeluridae. Fossils of the red panda have been discovered that are up to 4 million years old. You wouldn't think that such a cute critter existed that long ago. The red panda lives in Asia at high altitude in trees and mountains and has fur the color of cinnamon. Isn't it cute? They're small and are generally as big as a house cat, between 30 and 50 inches long. Like the giant panda, its diet consists mostly of bamboo and maybe some other small birds and rodents every now and then for some protein. Another similarity is the prominent wrist bone, which can be used like a thumb to grip stuff. Its long claws help it to hold onto tree bark and long tail help it balance. You need a good sense of balance when you're so high up. The face markings on a red panda are called tear tracks, which is appropriate as the panda is on the endangered species list. Deforestation has spelled disaster for its habitat. Because bamboo is disappearing, it means the red panda could too. It has to eat between 1 to 2 kilograms of bamboo per day to survive. That's 20 to 30% of its own body weight. Hunting and poachers have also greatly affected the red panda population. By the way, if you think this amazing animal looks familiar, it's probably because the red panda, and of course the fox, inspired the logo of Mozilla Firefox. You could even be watching this video on a Firefox browser. Coincidence? I think not. Number 8. The Tuatara. This next living fossil coexisted with the dinosaurs before its order died out 60 million years ago. The Tuatara lizards are found on the islands of New Zealand and Australia and live off of other little animals and eggs, amongst other things. They've even been known to eat their own young, so don't mess with them. On their neck and back, you'll see a crest made of spines. This is used both to attract mates and fend off opponents. It's very versatile. When it comes to the Tuatara, crest is best. Their coloring ranges from green to brown to red. They can actually change color during their lifespan. They grow to an impressive 1.6 feet and weigh up to 1.5 kilograms. The Tuatara is a big lizard, but its greatest threat is of the smaller variety. Rats and mice can quickly eat through their food supply, and the Tuatara's slow breeding means they're too slow to stop them. It's hard to keep up with the reproductive capabilities of a rodent. A Tuatara can live anywhere between 60 to 100 years, so they need to keep themselves topped up. It doesn't help that so many of them have been poached for private collections. The Tuatara have been protected by New Zealand law since 1895. If you're looking to go and see one up close, I recommend you try a zoo. Try avoiding going into their natural habitat because you may cause more harm than good. Number 7. Nautilus Cephalopod. This species of cephalopod is 500 million years old. A cephalopod is a kind of mollusk, but the Nautilus is an unusual example. It's part of a group of 7 alongside the Allonautilus that are living fossils. It's known for its hard shell, which it uses to protect itself. The shell also has pockets inside which fill with gas, making sure it stays buoyant. Unfortunately for the Nautilus, it's not the fastest growing of cephalopods. It takes around 5 to 10 years for it to develop, and it only lays approximately 12 eggs every year. It covers about 0.3 miles per day. They used to be masters of the sea, but younger and faster species have wrecked their reputation. Still, the Nautilus can reach a depth of 1,562 feet, which is pretty impressive. As with many of the species on this list, the Nautilus is in danger from humans. Its pretty shell is a highly desirable item, and a shocking number of Nautiluses die because people want one for their collection. In New Caledonia, 10,000 were caught for this horrible purpose. They're also captured for aquariums, which is a tragedy because obviously it's not the best environment, especially since they've been used to the ocean for millions of years. The worst of it is due to a lack of information. Did you know that the Nautilus is not protected by the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species? Number 6. The Purple Frog. The purple frog is so rare that people who discovered it have called it a once-in-a-century find. It's 7 centimeters long and was found in the state of Kerala in India in 2003. It spends most of its time in burrows and only ventures out during monsoon season when it's in search of a mate. Watch out, ladies! It's also called the pig-nose frog because of its pointy snout, which it uses to sniff out termites in the soil. Check out those powerful arms! This guy can really dig. When it comes to its back legs, however, it's a different story. When you see a frog, you expect it to hop around with its back legs. Not this one. The purple frog's back legs are so short it takes strides rather than leaps. Fun fact, almost the entire species is made up of males. Out of 135 purple frogs, only 3 are female. Maybe that's not so fun. Strangely, the purple frog isn't always purple. Sometimes they can be gray in color, but one thing's for sure, these stout-looking fellows know a thing or two when it comes to outlasting the dinosaurs. Number 5. The Mantis Shrimp. The mantis shrimp is truly a fearsome predator of the sea. The mantis shrimp is part of the stomatopoda order of crustaceans. It gets its name from those powerful second limbs which resemble those of the legendary praying mantis. And like its namesake, the mantis shrimp doesn't mess around when it comes to catching its dinner. Ranging from 1 to 30 centimeters, the mantis shrimp smashes the shells of its prey. Though if you don't have a shell, you're still in big trouble as it can stab you to death too. It lives underground, so you never know when one might come out to get you as you swim around minding your own business. There are 350 species of mantis shrimp, and they cover a wide area. The Squilla mantis can be found in the Mediterranean Sea and Atlantic Ocean. The Squilla impusa lives on the North American Atlantic coast. The Erato-Squilla oratoria is over in Japan, but it's regularly caught and eaten and it doesn't really have a great time of it. Almost makes me feel sorry for this formidable little creature. Number 4. The Hoatzin Bird. The Hoatzin is easily the most recognizable living fossil. Look at that crazy punk-style crest! This bird's a rock star! Along with its blue face and red eyes, it makes a striking addition to the wildlife living among the Amazon basin. You can find the Hoatzin in northern and central South America as well as the Atlantic coast. They don't travel far though, as their bulky proportions and stubby wings means they can't fly too well. It is the only member of its family and its evolutionary tree is missing a lot of branches. On the whole, the Hoatzins prefer to take it easy and can be spotted in the open where they hang out in groups. They like a forest habitat where they can live in trees and shrubs. A place by a river or lake is perfect for them because they build their nests over water. They have some characteristics that are not found in any other birds. For example, the chicks have little claws that help them climb trees, like a little pterodactyl. They eat young leaves and buds, which is just as well as they don't make the best hunters. This is down to their ungainly way of moving. They're known for crashing through the undergrowth, so you can hear them coming a mile away. They're also pretty noisy with a range of vocal patterns. In fact, some have described them as flying cows, which isn't too flattering. You'd think such a beautiful creature would have a better nickname. Number 3. The Koala. This cute animal is seen all the time, and whenever you think of Australia, you think of koalas. However, did you know it's also a living fossil? There's far more to this little guy than being cute and munching eucalyptus leaves. One discovery in 2013 revealed the koala has been in existence for 20 million years. The ancient ancestor of the koala was discovered when a skull was found in northern Australia. This koala was named Little Koala Dick Smithy in honor of Dick Smith, an adventurer famous for funding fossil research. Clever name, right? It was not only a third of the size of the koalas we know today, it was more agile than its descendant. We expect koalas to laze around in trees, but this one was a dynamo by comparison. There are 18 extinct species of koala dating back thousands of years. 15 million years ago, the northern Australian rainforest dried out, and the likes of Dick Smith's koala went with it. It's reassuring to know that while many koalas are no longer with us, their legacy lives on. Number 2. The Elephant Shrew. The African elephant shrew wins the race for the fastest living fossil. It's small, it's light, and it sure is fast. It can move at a surprising 8 miles per hour, and because it has long back legs, it's also called the jumping shrew. That can spell big trouble for the insects that make up its diet. Elephant shrews are insectivores, munching their way through grubs, spiders, and worms. Look at that long nose! Sniffing out a meal is not a problem for these guys. Measuring 10 to 30 centimeters, the elephant shrew lives anywhere between 2 to 5 years and is one of 20 different species. However, don't confuse it with the common shrew we see today. This living fossil is in a class all of its own. The elephant shrew enjoys its own company, hunting as soon as the sun comes up. It likes the undergrowth in a habitat like a forest or a grassland. This creature keeps things nice and tidy, clearing a series of pathways through its habitat in order to chase down its prey. Because it's small, it can run into a few predators, but it's really good at hiding and sleeps at night where it can avoid some of the nastier locals, such as snakes and birds of prey. Clearing a pathway also removes any obstacles in case it needs to sprint back home. And now for the most formidable of all, but first, remember to subscribe before you leave and click the notification bell. Number 1. The Crocodile. The crocodile is arguably the most famous reptile on Earth. I'm sure you'll agree there's nothing quite like it. Its strong connection to the dinosaurs makes it a great example of a living fossil. The skull structure of a crocodile is shared with its prehistoric ancestors, containing features such as holes behind the eye sockets. Fossils have been found of crocodile species that date back to the late Triassic epoch over 200 million years ago. So when I say this creature has been around a while, I really mean it. They're found in the northern and southern hemispheres in humid conditions. There are 23 known species and they can grow up to 20 feet long. They've been estimated to live as long as 70 years or more. The crocodile's jaws contain teeth that are not only razor sharp, but they live forever. Or rather, when the old teeth are done, new teeth rise up to replace them. No retirement to the old croc's home for these predators. A crocodile is amphibious by nature and has a body structure that enables it to move through the water with ease. Not only does its big tail give it power, but an I-beam structure of interlocking plates on its back keeps it nice and rigid so it can cut through a lake or a swamp like a knife through butter. It has receptors located in the scales of its mouth that can pick up vibrations, so try not to splash around too much if you're going swimming in your local swamp. The most impressive ability of the crocodile is the way it can submerge the majority of its body. Its eyes, ears, and nostrils stay above the surface, though if necessary, it can breathe underwater thanks to a system of membranous flaps which open and close. It lies as still as possible, waiting for an unsuspecting meal to come along. The crocodile then strikes without mercy, drowning its victim or ripping them to shreds. To make matters worse, they're nocturnal hunters, so you don't even see them coming a lot of the time. Ironically, we are a bigger threat to crocodiles than they are to us. We kill them to make things like handbags, and their meat is eaten worldwide. Plus, we are destroying their habitats through our constant expansion. The International Union for Conservation of Nature has placed species like the Chinese alligator and the Siamese crocodile on its endangered list. For animals with such a fearsome reputation, the crocodile is surprisingly persecuted. Thanks for watching! Be sure to subscribe before you leave, and I'll see you next time! Bye!